What makes a smart city? It's about integrating the physical, digital, and human. So, using technology to solve urban challenges, give easy access to services, in essence, making life more convenient. Hangzhou is ranked amongst Asia's top 10 smartest city and one step to China's smartest. Let's say I'm new to the city, which I am, and I'm looking for the subway. Where do I start? Ooh, map bot. So there's a handful of these now scattered around the main tourist areas in Hangzhou, apparently. Let's see what it does. Switch it to English. Oh, and it shows where all the public services nearby, so parking, toilet. Let's see how it works. And it will tell you where the nearest toilet is. So if I want one that's 75 meters away, what does it do? It's swiveling around. So this is perfect for the directionally challenged. Okay, so let's try and find that subway stop, the nearest one. And I think it is this one. And there it is. It has the directions for how to get there, including going through an underpass. And that's showing us the way. All right, perfect. So we're heading in that general direction and I can put my phone away. We want to catch a special subway train that's been put into operation for the Asian Games. Here it comes. So Line 19 started running almost exactly a year before the Games' scheduled opening, and it connects the airport to the main train stations to the east and west of the city, and it links up with, it looks like, most of the subway lines servicing different areas. And it takes only 50 minutes to cut across the entire city from the airport to the other end. It took us about the same amount of time by taxi just to get to the city center. And by the way, this OLED screen is exclusive to this Asian Games train. So it's quite traveler friendly. There's charging ports under the seats and also a rack for your luggage. And the train is here to stay even after the Asian Games wrap up. Several of China's tech giants are based here in Hangzhou. Alibaba, for instance, it works with the government on an AI city brain system to improve urban management. So for example, it monitors traffic, it adjusts traffic lights in order to reduce congestion. Now, it's reportedly shaved minutes of commutes. Now, that sounds insignificant, but it's actually no small feat. And crucially, it's helped to halve emergency response times. That said, there's still a definite advantage to seeing the city via shared bikes. So that there is one of the game stadiums. Now, to be honest, I'm not much of a runner, but this riverside running track is worth checking out. So there are these facial recognition checkpoints spaced out along the track, and I use an app on my phone to sync up and log in my info, and it will help keep track of my fitness levels. Well, it's all in the spirit of the game, so off I go.